get this done quickly? It's songs and lasers night at the roller skate pit. Let's dump everything in a garbage bag and throw it outside. We'll be done in 5 minutes. It's not like we're using this junk anyway. I mean, what's even in here? Receipts and sandwich wrappers.
Actually, it's all stuff from when we first started working together.
Look at how ridiculous we looked. And by we, I mean you, because I look totally cool in this picture.
We were just two guys with a dream, a garage, and a mouse. Didn't we even have a business plan?
Whoa!
Can you believe we used to work on such primitive machines? Hmm. Look how many centimeters thick this is. Look, modern smartphone, it's your ancestor. I feel bad for it too.
Didn't you write your first program on this thing?
Yeah, I never could get it to work though. I wasn't such an experienced programmer back in those days.
Oh, come on, I bet you could fix it now.
Huh, let's see if this works. Huh? Okay, hold on, let me blow on it.
Oh yeah, that always works. Huh? Ah!
He shoots.
It's good!
And I immediately found the problem. Someone stuffed a marshmallow into the back of the tablet.
Oh, wow, yeah! From our college prank marshmallow war, remember? I mean, I wonder who did that.
Duh! This is why I don't let you touch my things anymore.
Exit sleep mode.
Huh, maybe my programming wasn't the problem after all.
Initiating search for da-da-da-daddy.
Nah, the voice on this program must still have a glitch. It just mispronounced the word Ben as daddy.
My daddy is Ben.
Ben, what was this program supposed to do?
I don't even remember. I think I just made it because I was bored.
My daddy made me. My daddy is Ben. Ben is my daddy. Daddy Ben made me. I love you, daddy.
Daddy.
I didn't set out to make a computer that feels love. Personally, I find the idea of love complicated and icky. The only explanation is that the program I wrote has accidentally developed the personality of a small child. I guess I don't really have to explain that. It's just basic computer science, right?
Seed it. Don't want to see it. Ooh, a 4-hour background image of a fish tag. I've been meaning to check this out. Guys, we're infested with robot rats. Do we have any virtual cheese?
This isn't a robot rat. It's a computer that Ben brought to life, obviously.
How cute! Oh, he's got daddy's eyes.
Uh-huh. Sorry. Boomerang was getting in the way while I was cleaning, so I gave it wheels to move around and entertain itself.
Boomerang?
Hi. I'm Boomerang.
It likes to be called Boomerang.
I don't know, Ben. Computer kids are a big responsibility. From what I've seen on TV, you have to talk to your kids almost every day and warn them about stranger danger.
Well, I think of every program that I write as my offspring. Boomerang is no different.
Daddy, I'm stuck. It's Daddy and Dodge under you. Help, Daddy.
I'll sing you a lullaby. The modem noise always calms him down. So, like I was saying, this isn't gonna be a big deal at all.
Cut it out, Boomerang!
You can't get me, Ginger!
Everybody knock it off! Boomerang, slow down! Ginger, stop riling up the toddler tablet!
You can't shoot me because I have a force field that shoots back lasers! So when you shot me, you actually hit yourself!
No fair. Force fields are cheating.
Oh, man! This room looks worse than before. We're never gonna make it to Songs and Lasers Night at the Roller Skate Pit at this rate. I am so disappointed.
There's been an unexpected development. Boomerang's computer brain is growing quickly. He's already about Ginger's age.
Well, if you don't think you can go to Songs and Lasers Night, I understand. I mean, you kind of have a kid now. I can go with Hank.
Yes! Of course I want to go. It's a night with both songs and lasers.
Never mind.
We'll just quickly clean up the garage and be ready to go! Oh, my God!
Oh, man. I didn't think that would actually work!
Ginger!
Let's throw things at him while he can't move.
Guys, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to go out tonight.
Don't give up just yet. I'm gonna make a call to someone who might just give us some help. She's an expert.
Guys, get a clue. Just because I'm a girl doesn't mean I know how to babysit. Anyway, I charge by the hour. Oh, and I'll keep him away from the TV, and you just tell me when it's bedtime is.
Oh, you are a lifesaver, Angela. Ugh, I was starting to think we wouldn't make it to the coolest laser and music and roller skate theme night in town.
Oh, it's fine, and also fine that you weren't gonna invite me to that fun thing. So, can I meet the little dude?
Yeah, he's around here somewhere. Boomerang!
Boomerang! Oh, his name is Boomerang. Hey, little guy.
Sup?
We're gonna have so much fun while Ben and Tom go out, okay? Does that sound like a good idea? Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Why is this old lady talking to me like I'm some kind of kid? I'm not a kid, okay? I'm like 4 hours old.
Hey, Boomerang! Did you forget we were just about to start playing King Pirate Robot?
Pirates are so done.
You take that back! I can't even be around you anymore, Boomerang! You've changed!
Whatever.
His programming must have upgraded again. He now has the personality of a surly preteen. Oh, man, I hope he doesn't fry his circuits with all these upgrades.
He'll be fine. Now let's get out of here before Angela changes her mind.
You know, I don't really need a babysitter. Why don't you just let me come with you?
I don't know, Boomerang. I kind of need a break, okay?
Come on. I've never been to a party. I'd be great at a party. Check my mood.
Look, I'm not taking you because you're just a program that I wrote. And I need time to myself, okay?
Well, if you don't want me around, then I'll just go.
Just go.
Wait, Boomerang, I didn't mean that the way it sounded.
You have to pull it to open it.
I hate everyone and nobody understands me. I want to listen to my music. Teen stuff, blah, blah, blah.
Tom, it looks like I won't be going to the roller skate pit after all. Boomerang, you're right. I can't just ignore you. What do you say we go out and get a milkshake? Just the two of us.
Well, I don't have a mouth or any way to consume food, but sure, whatever.
So then I rewrote all your code, and that's how you were born.
Gross. I did not need to hear that.
It's perfectly natural.
Ew, Dad. Hey, do you think that air conditioning unit is looking at me?
Air conditioning? Well, I'm not sure how I'd be able to tell that. Maybe?
It doesn't matter. Someone with that many amps wouldn't have any use for a guy like me anyway.
Hey, never say that about yourself. You are a great application, sweet Boomerang, and I am proud of you.
Really?
Oh, wow, Ben! You really missed out, man. I mean, the roller skate pit was a life-changing experience. I mean, I don't think I'm ever gonna look at inline footwear the same way again. I mean, you guys made up.
You know what? We have. This day hasn't gone the way I planned it, but maybe that's okay, because I've got Boomerang now.
And I've got you, Pop. Update available. Young adult mode. Error.
Not enough
memory. Error. Circuit overload. Shutting
down.
Boomerang.
Shutting
down.
Boomerang.
Shutting down.
Boomerang!
Did I break another computer thing? I didn't mean to. I didn't even bring a marshmallow this time.
No! Boomerang's clunky old computer body can't contain his rapidly expanding mind. Why is old technology such junk? Didn't old-time people know that they should just make good things?
Wait, if it's the old technology that's junk, maybe you could put Boomerang in your new phone.
But that would connect Boomerang to the internet. Once he's there, he'll be out in the harsh world. I won't be able to protect him.
Goodbye, Dad. Boomerang out.
You protected him for a quarter of a day, Ben. It's time to let him go into that harsh world on his own.
Why does everyone say being a parent is super easy?
Pretty sure no one's ever said that.
Well, that makes sense then, because it's not easy at all. Huh? There you go, little guy.
Whoa,
the internet.
Boomerang, promise me you'll stay out of trouble. Use numbers and letters in your passwords, avoid spam emails, and Don't touch Papa pads.
Yeah, I know, Dad. I'm not running on basic, duh.
That's my boomerang. Email home, okay?
Okay, sure. You got it, Dad. Gotta go.
They grow up so fast.
Yeah, but hey, he's moved on to something really great. I mean, who knows what kind of amazing, brilliant, mind-blowing stuff that kid is up to right now.
Woo! Party!
No cake today, Ginger. We're getting ready for Garage Feast Day.
What's that?
One of my top four best holidays. When we go through the fridge, take all the food that's about to expire and turn it into a delicious feast.
It's a celebration of friendship. And of not wasting groceries.
We never do that at my house. My parents don't keep old food.
That's so sad.
Why don't you celebrate with us this year? We're already having one special guest.
Really? Who?
Stack these plates! Vacuum the dust! Come on! Everything has to be perfect for my computer son, Boomerang!
Aw, what's that little guy been up to since that day he came to life, grew up, and moved out on his own?
Undoubtedly something incredible. His advanced computing powers may have allowed him to unlock the secrets of the universe, or to find an alternate universe. It's sure to be something with some kind of universe. Straighten your postures, everyone! That must be... Boomerang?
Hey, Daddy-o. Hope you don't mind, I brought my girlfriend. This is Dottie. Dottie, Dad.
He's kind of a nerd.
Boomerang, like the tie-dye. I bet that really freaks out the man.
A lot of scientists have been known to rock the mad genius style. Even Einstein was quite the nonconformist.
Sure, only I'm not a scientist.
What? Why? Don't tell me you're a mathematician.
Well, it all began after I uploaded my mind to the internet. I learned every single formula, date, and measurement there is to know. But it didn't make me happy. And that's when I found it.
If you found the meaning of life, no spoilers, please. I'm on my own journey.
Even better, I found love. Dottie taught me that there's so much more to life than science.
That's literally not true.
There is art. She's an artist, and she taught me to be an artist, too.
An artist!
So, what kind of art do you guys do? Sculpture? Papier-mâché?
Come with us and we'll show you. Our work is on display at the Arrogance Gallery downtown. Just be careful. Some of the pieces might blow your mind.
Let's check it out. I mean, Boomerang is a genius. I bet whatever art he's doing is really impressive. I don't get it.
It's a hamburger with a tie. You're right, really impressive. Great stuff.
Okay, but that's just one piece. Ooh, I mean, this one here is really good. It makes me think of planes and books. So it's really a comment on engineering and literature.
Admit it, Boomerang wasn't built to be an artist.
I don't know, I'm no art expert. Maybe this is cutting edge.
No. I don't like this at all. When it comes to art, I like everything, but not this. That supply closet is magnificent. The colors, the feeling in his face.
Garage, feast your eyes on this classic holiday treat. Yogurt a la mold.
And it smells right. My parents would definitely toss this.
Seriously, that's so sad.
Allow me to quote from the classic Garage Feast Day story, The Friendly Fridge Worm. Just because something is spoiled doesn't mean you have to throw it away.
These oranges, I can't even tell that there's anything wrong with them.
Wait, let me see that. Why is this fruit so fresh and juicy? Angela, you told me you found these old oranges way in the back of a deep, dark cupboard.
I did find moldy oranges in the back of a cabinet, but I kind of forgot them, so I stopped at the grocery store.
The grocery store?
How could you?
I thought you understood this holiday.
Uh-uh. What do you think? Brilliant attack on the corporate world, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that is exactly what Ben was saying when he saw all of this.
I knew he would understand. Companies are the worst.
The worst!
Hey!
Except for the company me and Ben run from our garage, right?
Actually, I was going to suggest that you both quit your jobs. Spend a year backpacking. No! Learn to live. Oh, that gives me an idea for my next piece. Dottie, print out the following images. Sad face. Money bag. Stink cloud. Smiling boo.
Come on, Ben. You can't hide in the corner all day. You're gonna have to tell Boomerang you like his art.
What if it's easier to make Boomerang not like his art? It's clear that old printer has corrupted his mainframe, so I've written a program that will wipe his memory.
Oh! No, Ben. Brainwashing your son is not good parenting.
I'm teaching him. This is just like signing him up for swim lessons. Just give me that. No!
Hey, Daddy-O, I want you to see my newest piece. I call it, You Should Sell Your Company and Become a Hiker, Dad.
Ah!
Oh, no!
Hey, there you are. I've been looking for you. We're gonna be late for the feast.
I don't wanna be in the same room as Boomerang. He's turned his back on everything I've taught him.
He's made some odd choices. I don't know why he likes Dottie.
Not for her voice, that's for sure.
But he's still your computer, son. I mean, didn't you ever do anything your parents didn't like?
No, I was the perfect boy.
What about when you opened a black hole in your mom's attic? I know she wasn't happy about that.
I guess, yes, that time she confiscated all of my antimatter.
So maybe...
If she had forcefully, logically stated her concerns, I would have listened and canceled the experiment!
Not what I was going for.
You are right. I cannot hide, and I should not hide. I will go to the feast and give Boomerang a piece of my mind. Thank you, Tom!
But you completely missed the point of... Oh...
Welcome to Garage Feast Day Dinner, everyone. A very delicious and money-saving tradition. Fortunately, I was able to recover from the orange slice disaster. Angela?
As a first-time feaster, I like how we're all together. Also, I like watching Hank be mad all day.
Watch it, Buster. You're about to be a last-time feaster.
To being together.
To be together.
It sure is always great to be together. Maybe next year it'll be a slightly different group of us. For instance, Boomerang might have a different girlfriend.
Dad, don't tell me you think me and Dottie are going to break up.
Well, since you bring it up, she is a lot older than you, and she is into art, which is clearly ridiculous.
So, who wants questionable olives?
Oh, yeah? Running a stupid, boring computer company is ridiculous.
Ha! What I do is boring. You draw tiny little identical pictures slightly spaced out differently.
Okay, time for a classic Garage Day Feast game. Angela, why don't you go first?
You just don't get it, Dad. This show is going to launch our art careers.
Launch it right into the garbage, maybe. Your art is bad. Go back to science. You'll appreciate my honesty when you are living in a space station.
Could you please not fight during the meal I worked on all day with barely any help from anyone?
Good point, Hank. Someone please pass the potatoes with the roots growing out of them.
Sure thing, Pop. Potatoes coming right up.
Oh! Hey!
Wait! That's almost like you did that on purpose.
No, that one was an accident. But this one is on purpose.
No.
What the? That was definitely on purpose!
How did you figure that out? Science?
Angela! Don't!
No!
That's good for another 2 days! You're ruining my masterpiece!
This was a disaster. The room is destroyed, the meal is wrecked, and Boomerang and Dottie angrily left.
I don't see how things could have gone differently. My computer son thought he was an artist.
You know what's worse?
What?
Having no computer son at all.
Wow, you really spoiled everything.
He gets it, Ginger. You don't need to be cruel.
No, I mean, are you all forgetting the lesson of Garage Feast Day? Just because something is spoiled doesn't mean you have to throw it away.
Oh, I see.
So true.
Huh. Hank taught me that.
Hey, that's right. Ginger, thanks for showing us what Garage Feast Day is all about.
See, Ben? There's a way to fix this.
Yes, definitely.
Time to dread my dreams. My dad was right. I am not an artist.
No! Stop the shredding! I was wrong. It's not my job to tell you how to live your life. It's my job to support you. This drawing of us is made from the food we threw at each other at dinner. From what I understand about art, this should work as a symbolic apology.
But you said my art was bad.
How would I know? Look what a bad job I did with this painting.
Wow, it's terrible. I love it. Thanks, Dad.
Ha! You said it, Dottie.
It's a Garage Feast Day miracle.
Oh!